Hello, hi everyone. This is Shreeja. Welcome to Skinoreal, where I talk all things skincare. So if you like skincare related content, then make sure that you subscribe. Likewise, you can also follow me on Instagram, where I post more regularly. Now, you guys have been asking me about a body skincare routine. So today, I'm finally going to do it. When it comes to body skincare routine, I really don't believe in spending a lot or, you know, going after very luxurious body butters. But then again, I have been a skincare junkie since I was 13 and I have a pretty solid skincare routine for my face and for my body as well. Now, I'm really proud of this fact because I see a lot of people neglecting body care. But I feel body skin is also a very important part of your skincare. And you need to set up a healthy body skincare practice from the start, along with identifying what products work for you if you want that full healthy body glow. Now, if you're someone who's watching this video and who is just into basic moisturizing and cleaning their body and it is working fine for you, then it is really enough. Trust me, you don't need to do these extra stuff here and there. It's a nice thing to add, but then again, it's not an essential as long as you are moisturizing your body, cleansing your body, and using SPF. I mean, these are the basics in skincare. Rest of the things that we do, adding actives, toners, essentials, are actually just these few extra steps that we take for a better skin. So starting with the basic thing that people neglect when it comes to body care. Our body skincare routine actually starts in the shower. Yes, you heard me right. I know we enjoy taking these long hot showers, but trust me, that is one of the most damaging things for your body and it can really make your skin dry and dehydrated. So I highly recommend that you limit your shower time to 5 to 10 minutes and stick to using lukewarm water. Trust me, you guys, you will really see the difference. If you're someone who has flaky and dry skin all over the body, making this minor switch will actually show significant results over long time. So try doing that. Another thing that people often forget when it comes to body care is exfoliation. Now wait, if you think that by exfoliation I mean using those harsh, horrible walnut scrub all over my body, then definitely you got me wrong. By body exfoliation, I simply mean using the chemical exfoliator that I use on my face, even on my body. I don't have any separate scrub for my body. I just use the regular chemical exfoliator that I have been using in my facial skincare routine on my body once or twice a week. And this really helps prevent ingrown hairs. Trust me, like this is one, if you're someone who's prone to ingrown hair and those bumps after waxing, then exfoliating your skin regularly can really prevent that from happening. And also it helps with those tiny marks and bumps that you get after waxing. You won't see results immediately, but after exfoliating your body skin for 2 to 3 months, you will definitely see a reduction in your ingrown hair. So now coming to the products that I like to use regularly in my body skincare routine. And of course, the first product is a cleanser. But I'll tell you what, I don't use a cleanser on my body every day. Yes, you heard me right. No, I'm not some disgusting person who doesn't like to keep clean or whatever. It's just that there's a scientific reason for it. So the skin on your body is not exposed to as much pollutants and dirt as the skin on your face, and you actually don't need to clean it every day using a cleanser. I do use a cleanser twice or thrice a week depending upon the outdoor cardio activity that I've had, or if I'm out entire day and I feel I need to use a proper cleanser, then definitely I go for it. But in the morning, I definitely skip a regular cleanser. Having said that, I do use a cleanser on my underarms, groin area, or wherever there is skin fold, because you do need to use a cleanser there. Developing this habit was very difficult for me, but say I have been doing this since last 1 year, and I think my skin on the body is much more moisturized and hydrated. Also, if you're someone who is more prone to flakiness and dry patches, then try staying away from those cleansers that smell amazing, because they really do contain harsh surfactants that can dehydrate your skin in the long run. Now, like my face, even for my body, I prefer a mild surfactant. One of my personal choice when it comes to cleanser is Aveeno Baby Wash. It is an oatmeal-based cleanser and it's a non-stripping. It doesn't smell nice. Literally, there's no smell to it. But it is so gentle on your skin, and personally it's my favorite. Another one is again from Aveeno. It's their daily moisturizing body wash. It is also great. I'm personally a huge fan of Aveeno body care products because the key ingredients is oatmeal, and oatmeal is so rich in lipids and proteins and is excellent for moisturizing and hydrating your skin. Oatmeal also has soothing and anti-inflammatory properties for your skin, and in general, if you have dry, flaky and sensitive skin, it is really good for you. Having said that, I do sometimes enjoy scent in my body care products, and recently I have tried this cleanser. It's Olive Oil Cleanser by Petal Fresh. It's a new brand that is available on Sublime, and I tried their shampoo. I quite enjoyed that. So then I thought of trying their body care products and have been quite enjoying that cleanser. It is non-stripping, non-drying, and it has like a good floral scent to it. It's not too overpowering, but if you're someone who likes good smelling body care products, then you can give it a try. I am also personally a huge fan of Palmer's when it comes to body care. Their cocoa butter balm, the huge 100 gram or 200 gram tub which has that thick cocoa butter, is my absolute favorite. I have been using that product for like 10 years now, and I just keep running back to it during winter times. It is such a multi-purpose product. You can use it all over your body and even on your lips as a lip balm. I highly recommend it if you're someone who has dry skin and is looking for a really hydrating body butter. They also have a Palmer's Raw Shea lotion version, which is also a very good thick moisturizer. So if you have dry skin, you can definitely give it a try. Nivea also has this cocoa butter moisturizer that is oil in moisturizer version. That is also a good option. It's not extremely hydrating, but if you are not looking for that extra layer of hydration, this can work for you. And also it smells really nice. That scent won't stay for long, but if you're someone who wants a good smelling body product, then Nivea oil in moisturizer, the cocoa butter formula, is really nice. Now moving on to the last tip that I want to share with you guys, and probably this is the one that has made the biggest difference in my body care, and that is using coconut oil in my bath water. Yes, you heard me right. So I don't do this in summers. I only do this in winters, once or twice a week. I just add 1 tablespoon of coconut oil to a bucket full of water. I stir it, leave it there for about 5 to 10 minutes. So the water cools down a bit, and then I take shower with it, and after that I just use a soft cotton towel to pat dry my body so that I get rid of all the excess oil and water. This has been a game changer in my body skincare routine, and for the right reasons, because coconut oil is extremely rich in essential fatty acids and is such an excellent source of moisturizer. I'm not a huge fan of using coconut oil on my face because yes, it is highly comedogenic, but for your body skin, it works really well. It also has anti-inflammatory properties and is good for you. If you experience irritation in your skin very frequently, then I highly recommend you give this method a try. By doing this, like, I have also tried using coconut oil 1 hour before my shower, but somehow that left my skin feeling sticky. This one really doesn't, and that's the reason I love using coconut oil in my bath water. Because otherwise, if you leave the coconut oil and then you take shower, and you guys know that I don't use a cleanser regularly, so it is really very sticky and I don't enjoy that feeling. So in my opinion, this bath method works really well for me. So that is all I have for you guys today. I think having a body skincare routine is again as important as a facial skincare routine. Also, don't forget your SPF when you're going out. I personally don't use body sunscreen when I'm staying indoors. I know I should be, but I just get lazy when it comes to that. But yes, when I'm going out, I make sure that I apply proper broad spectrum sunscreen even on my body. Also, if you are getting overwhelmed by watching this video and you think that you need to buy this body butter or this moisturizer, or your current body skincare routine is not good enough, guys, please don't panic buy anything, because honestly, as long as you're moisturizing and cleaning your body properly, it is really good enough. I have just shared few tips and tricks that have personally worked for me, and these are few products that I have been using for years and I love them. So please, as I always say, skincare is something very personal. Stick to what is working for you and always take my tips as a guideline and not a general rule. Also, if you enjoyed watching this video, then please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. I'll see you next time. Bye.